Tonight's playing around in the shop is accompanied by Stir Stick Stout from Half Pints Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as having notes of dark roast coffee and semi-sweet chocolate offset by the classically bright Golding's hops. So tonight, I'm just digging through my box of environmental sensors here and taking a look at the various different temperature sensors that I've got that'll all work with your standard Arduino or microcontroller projects. And there is a surprising variety of them, and I don't even have all of them available. This is just a smattering that I've got. So we will start with this guy here, which is a thermistor, a temperature-sensitive resistor. So a lot of the Arduino starter kits will come with a little module like this, which has the thermistor just sitting here, standing off on its legs, and three pins. And there's a little resistor down there as well, but it's less important. The thermistor is just this little bead on here. There's other thermistor boards that you might find in a starter kit that look more like this one, which has the same little thermistor sitting up there. And you can get its analog reading directly out of it as well, just like before, just like on this board. But this one also has a little comparator and a potentiometer on here and a smattering of resistors and whatnot. The comparator basically compares the resistance of the thermistor to whatever you set here and sets a digital high or low depending on which side of the threshold you're on. So thermistors, as the name implies, are a thermal or temperature sensitive resistor. The resistance of the thermistor varies based on the temperature of its surrounding environment. You can get them in various different base resistances, but these ones, all three of these, and most of the common ones that you'll get with Arduino starter kits and whatnot, are 10k ohms at 25 Celsius room temperature. And then their resistance will drop as the temperature increases, which means that they are a negative temperature coefficient thermistor, or NTC. PTC, positive temperature coefficients, also exist, but they're a little bit less common in this hobby world. So as you can see, it's pretty close to 10k ohms right at room temperature here. And if I just reach in and warm it up, see the resistance starts dropping as the temperature increases on this guy, which can be pretty handy. And I mean, it's just a resistor, so it's really easy to talk to and deal with. So to use them with an Arduino, all you have to do is connect it to an analog input and set up a voltage divider with this little resistor here. I mean, it doesn't have to be this one, you know, it could be any 10K resistor. And I went through my bin of 10K resistors and selected this one because it's as close as I could find to actually 10K. You know, they've got a percentage tolerance on them. But so that creates a voltage divider between ground, an analog input pin, this guy, and 5 volts. So because the Arduino can't measure resistance directly, you have to measure the voltage across that voltage divider. But as you can see, it's just reading the temperature. It's showing you a little bit of what's going on underneath here, showing that it's calculated that it's 10.784 ohms, and for that, 23.31 degrees. If I warm it up on my fingers, we should see it starts rising down here. There you go. So that's the most common and probably most straightforward one, but there's plenty of other temperature sensors available. These guys, for instance, this is a thermocouple. It looks kind of similar to the thermistor at the tip, but what it really is simply two wires with two dissimilar metals in that little blob on the end there. And those dissimilar metals will generate a tiny little voltage when you apply heat to them. And these things will operate over a very wide range of temperatures. They often come with multimeters that have temperature sensing capability built into them, such as, you know, this Kiwetz, but the Fluke meters do them, and other brands are available. So if we connect this guy and put him into temperature monitoring, you'll see that just in free air, this thing is measuring about 21 Celsius. Then I warm it up. Notice it jumps really fast when you start warming it up. That is another benefit of these. Additionally, they can withstand and measure accurately very high temperatures. That was just the heat shrink burning off it. You see, it went up over 500 degrees just from that flame very quickly, and it was dropping off quickly in free air. Again, there's not a model thermal mass there, so they react very quickly. There's a bunch of different types of thermocouples. There's a Wikipedia page that explains it all, of course, and also explains better and more detailed how the what's called the Seebeck effect of that two metal interaction with the heat is in there. So I'll link that down below. But these ones, and the most common ones, are defined as a K-type thermocouple. Here's another type you might find fairly commonly. And again, it's just got that little tiny sensor on the end of it. And there is the ranges that a K-type can handle. This one with just the cloth on it is one of these. So it can handle, you know, -58 to 399 Fahrenheit accurately. But if you get one with a little bit more heavy-duty jacketing on it, it can go all the way up to 700 Celsius or down to -50 Celsius quite comfortably. And the other types, other than, you know, these being the type K, can be selected for other ranges of temperatures. However, if you're using a thermocouple with an Arduino or most circuitry, you need an amplifier board. This one is a MAX 6675 chip on it, which is both an amplifier and an analog to digital converter. So then you just talk to your Arduino or whatever microcontroller using the data pins here. This particular one is one of the ones that the wiring is set up for higher temperature and actually is designed to screw into, you know, a flame tube or a heater. Furnaces and whatnot will have this type in them to monitor if there is a pilot light and if there is a flame and stuff like that. And they can operate comfortably in that environment for years. So here it is using, again, just a library directly from the Arduino library manager, nothing too fancy. And as you can see, it is showing 27 Celsius or 81 Fahrenheit approximately. If I put my lighter underneath the tip of it again, you'll see that it jumps up real fast as the flame heats the thing up. But I don't want to hold my hand there doing that for very long. But there you go. Another one that works nice and easy in Arduino world. So here's another common type of temperature sensor that often comes in Arduino starter kits. This guy is called a DHT11 temperature sensor. There is also a very similar looking one, although it often comes with a different color case, which is called a DHT22. And these family are a temperature and humidity sensor, which outputs in a digital format. So it's, again, got the analog to digital stuff built into it already. Just three pins. Power, ground, and a data pin. The actual DHT11 module itself has four pins on it, but you only need three of them to get it going. And the starter kit modules will typically only have three pins on them. And those guys just go in there, plug them in, and we have temperature and humidity readings. So this particular script that I'm using is, like I said, just an example from the library. It is showing me that it is 56% humidity in my room. I don't think it's that humid, but I do have the humidifier running when I'm not recording videos. It's showing between 21 and 22 degrees Celsius, whatever that is in Fahrenheit, and the heat index, which is just mathematically calculated from the humidity and temperature. Here's a sketch that I happen to be using. This is one from Adafruit, but there are several others. This particular one will work with the DHT11 or the DHT22 that I mentioned, which I don't have one of here right now, or the DHT21. And it just uses its library, DHT.h, to do most of the magic. Very little for the user to do when you're programming with this thing. And like any sketch, you can use the temperature that you get back for anything that your heart desires in your project. You can use it as a thermometer, thermostat. You can
turn on the fan in your greenhouse if the humidity gets too high, or whatever you want. It's your project, and this is a super easy way to deal with it.
But if you want to get fancier, there are other types of temperature sensors as well, and these ones don't tend to come in the starter kits. This one looks like a transistor, but it is really a Dallas 18B20 OneWire temperature sensor. OneWire is a bus topology that allows you to both communicate and power the device on a single wire. Plus ground. I guess you don't count ground. Whatever. Anyway, these are kind of neat. They're a little bit expensive, but one advantage they have is with that one-wire bus, you can put multiple on the same bus. So you can have multiple temperature sensors scattered around your project. And each one has its own hard-coded, serial number on it, burned in from the factory, unique, theoretically. So you can address multiples of them. I'm not going to do that experiment right now because I couldn't find a library that worked very well with that. But I will demonstrate just the basics of it. Another one that's very easy to do wiring on. You just need the signal wire, a ground wire, and a power wire is optional. I'm doing it just for the demonstration here because it's easier. And then a pull-up resistor on the data line. Oops, that goes over there. Come on, get in. There we go. And then, again, just a sketch from the library, power it up, and away we go.
As I said, there's multiple libraries and multiple demo sketches for this one. This is the one that I happen to choose to use, and it's, once again, right out of the library manager in the Arduino IDE. This one just does a call to the OneWire library and the Dallas temperature library and does some math magic and pumps it out. And here we go. It's showing 23.5 degrees. And as always, I'll use my standard test to warm it up. I'll put my fingers on it and you can see that the temperature is rising. Again, that can be a handy one. You can get them in a weatherproof version. I don't have one of those handy right now. I've just got this one here, but another cool option.
There's one other one I've got in here. Where did you go? There you are. This is called a BMP180. It's fairly common and fairly cheap. The sensor is just this little square guy down in the corner here, and it's made by Bosch, a fairly large company that you may have heard of in the industrial world. They make a few different environmental sensors. This BMP180 measures temperature and barometric pressure. There are some other ones that are you see in Arduino world as well, which can measure humidity and a few other things as well, but I don't have one of those right now. So we'll just focus on this guy. And like so many of them, it has the analog to digital conversion in it, and just voltage, ground, serial clock, serial data, you know, standard I squared C stuff, and away you go. As simple as that. Four wires, one simple sketch using any one of several libraries that are available on the Arduino Library Manager, and away you go.
Here's the script that I'm running, and once again, it is using an Adafruit library, but there are other libraries available in the Arduino IDE. That's useful if you've got just a raw module. It's only a 3.3, but this breakout board has voltage conversion, so it can handle 5 volts. It speaks I2C, and well, let's just look at the result. There we go. It's showing again 25 degrees Celsius. Let's pause this for a second. It's showing the barometric pressure. It's guessing, without me calibrating it to what the real barometric pressure is here today, it's guessing I'm at about 179.1 meters above sea level. But with some other calculations, it thinks my real altitude. And I'm not sure what the difference in those two is, but yeah, so if I knew, if I had my own barometer or checked the weather forecast, I could put in the actual numbers for my location today and it could figure out the altitude more carefully. But that's close enough for now. And you could again use that to check the difference between when you start the script and when you drop it down a well or send it up in a hot air balloon or something like that. And that would be accurate enough to give you an altitude above ground level. But for today's purposes, I was just looking at it for its temperature measuring capabilities.
So there we go. Just a quick look at, what is that, five different inexpensive, hobby grade, although fairly accurate for the most part, temperature sensors that you can use in your Arduino projects. All of them are using libraries that are in the library manager, and most of them, there are multiple options available. This guy's not even using a library, it's just using a little bit of raw code that I found on the internet, and I'll link to that below as well for the thermistor. But yeah, the rest of it's all fairly standard stuff, and most Arduino starter kits are going to come with one or more of these types of temperature sensors in them. So you can do temperature-based projects. You know, turn on a fan if it gets too hot, open the window, turn on a heater if it gets too cold, or just report the temperature in your fridge. I used one of these to monitor my beer fridge for a while when I was first setting it up. I don't know. I thought it was kind of interesting, and I hope some of you got some useful information out of this. Thanks for watching, everybody. Questions and comments down below, as usual. I'll talk to you later.